Good morning. Last time we derived Bernoulli's equation. Today we are going to do 7 demonstrations of Bernoulli's principle.
Flippin' physics.
Bobby, tell me about Bernoulli's equation.
Okay. For a fluid, pressure plus 1/2 fluid density times fluid speed squared plus fluid density times gravitational field strength times vertical height is constant. In other words, all of those at one point in a fluid equals all of those at another point in the fluid.
Correct. In all of our demonstrations today, we are going to assume the differences in heights are negligible compared to the differences in speeds and pressures. In other words, the variable y in the equation is comparatively very small, and that whole term can be neglected or crossed out. And air is not an ideal fluid. It is certainly compressible. That means Bernoulli's equation, which Bobby just gave us, is not strictly correct in these demonstrations. However, Bernoulli's principle, which states that an increase in speed corresponds to a decrease in pressure, is still correct. So yeah, air is not an ideal fluid. However, we could still demonstrate Bernoulli's principle, which shows that when the speed of a fluid increases, the pressure of the fluid decreases. For example, our first demonstration is a strip of paper taped to the edge of a table. When I use a hairdryer to blow air over the top of the strip of paper, the speed of the air above the paper is larger than the speed of the air under the paper. Therefore, the pressure above the paper is less than the pressure below the paper. This creates an upward pressure difference on the strip of paper, causing the paper to lift upward.
Oh, that is the same thing which causes lift on an airplane wing, right, Mr. P?
Correct, Billy.
Yeah, the shape of an airplane wing makes it so the air moving over the top of the wing is moving faster than below the wing. That makes it so the pressure above the wing is less than the pressure below the wing, which causes lift on the wing and helps planes to fly.
Yes, Billy, Bernoulli's principle is one of the physics principles which helps planes to fly. Our second demonstration involves 2 empty soda cans. When I use a straw to blow air between the 2 cans, the speed of the air between the 2 cans is larger than the speed of the air outside of the cans. Therefore, the pressure between the 2 cans is less than the pressure outside of the cans. This causes the 2 cans to initially move towards one another. Again, the very first movement of the 2 cans is towards one another. And yes, one of the 2 cans does move before the other one. This is probably because the coefficients of static friction are not exactly the same, and the fast-moving air is probably closer to one can, the one that moves first. Okay, in our third demonstration, I place a ping pong ball in a funnel and blow upward through the funnel. Bo, please explain what you see going on here.
Sure. When you blow through the funnel, the air flows across the bottom and around the sides of the ping pong ball, but the air above the ping pong ball is essentially at rest. That means the pressure to the sides and below the ping pong ball is less than the pressure above the ping pong ball. Therefore, blowing air through the funnel actually causes a difference in pressure downward on the ping pong ball, which draws the ping pong ball toward the funnel. I bet you cannot blow the ping pong ball out of the funnel, right, Mr. P?
That is correct, Bo. In fact, for the fourth demonstration, let's turn the funnel upside down and blow downwards through the funnel. Now, the airspeed above the ping pong ball is more than below the ping pong ball, which causes an upward pressure difference on the ping pong ball, which is large enough to suspend the ping pong ball in the funnel. As long as I can keep blowing air through the funnel. And now, our fifth demonstration. I am blowing upward through a straw at a ping pong ball. Billy, please explain why the ping pong ball tends to not fall out of the stream of air moving upward from the straw as long as the air is flowing.
Absolutely. Can you pause the ball when it is to the left of the straw?
Sure.
Okay. When the ping pong ball moves out of the stream of air, or to the left in the pause demonstration, the air to the right of the ping pong ball is moving faster than the air to the left of the ping pong ball. That means the pressure to the right of the ping pong ball is less than the pressure to the left of the ping pong ball. That pressure difference pushes the ping pong ball to the right, and now unpause it.
There you go.
That makes it so the difference in pressure on the ping pong ball always draws the ping pong ball towards the stream of air moving upward from the straw, as long as you can blow air through the straw.
Thank you, Billy. You can actually show the same effect in a larger and longer sixth demonstration with a leaf blower and a beach ball. In fact, you can hold the leaf blower at an angle to suspend the beach ball in the air. Again, the air over the top of the beach ball is moving faster than the air below the beach ball. That makes it so the pressure above the beach ball is less than the pressure below the beach ball. This causes an upward difference in pressure and suspends the beach ball in the air. And the beach ball is pulled back into the stream of air coming from the leaf blower, just like the ping pong ball was drawn back into the stream of air coming from the straw. And honestly, it's just really fun to do. But this seventh and last demonstration may be even more fun. We still use the leaf blower, but now we point it over the top of a roll of toilet paper. Honestly, this is basically just like our first demonstration of blowing air over a strip of paper, only we have amped it up a bit. The air is moving faster, and we have a lot more paper. Again, the air moving over the top of the toilet paper is moving faster than below the toilet paper. That causes the pressure above the toilet paper to be less than the pressure below the toilet paper. The upward difference in pressure causes lift on the toilet paper, which holds it in the air, just like an airplane wing. Again, these are all demonstrations of Bernoulli's principle, demonstrating that an increase in fluid speed corresponds to a decrease in pressure, which can cause lift on objects, and can be quite fun. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.